asked all the time, why do I make this commute, or why don't I work in Oakland or in San Francisco? And the answer is because I like the shop that I work at. I love the shop that I work at. My name is Akira Mink. I'm a barber and I'm a woman. Why barbering? I remember being in high school, and what really just took my mind and just blew it up, just blew it away from me, was the fact that at that time the boys were rocking the double line. So this was back in like 2003, 2004, and it just intrigued me that not only could somebody get one line super sharp and crispy, but they got two lines super sharp and crispy. So just that right there really blew my mind away. You know, it was like the precision in that, the time in that, the focus in that. I just was so intrigued by it. And that's when I fell in love with barbering. I fell in love with barbering when I was 17 years old, but it took me years to actually get up the courage to go to barber school because, you know, according to everyone, women aren't barbers. Women can't be barbers. We're supposed to be hairstylists. We're supposed to play with dye and long hair and do braids and do weaves and stuff like that. But none of that interested me at all. What interested me was a clean fade, a clean taper, a clean lineup. That interested me so much. I remember I had an acquaintance back in the day, and I remember, you know, anytime somebody would ask me what it is that I wanted to do or what it is that I saw myself doing, I would always say, I want to be a barber. And according to that person, they said, you can't be a barber because you're a girl. The saddest part about this story is that I believed them. You know, they told me I couldn't do something, and I believed somebody that told me that I could not be something. I regret that day every single day, because I know if I would have started working on my passion back then when I wanted to, I would be way beyond where I am right now, you know. But I feel that God has a plan, and there's a purpose for his timing, and I don't think that I would really do it any other way, because back then and in my teenage years and my early 20s and stuff, like, it just wasn't a good time for me, you know. Emotionally, mentally, it wasn't a good time for me back then. So I feel he set up me becoming a barber and me really taking my dream and you know, going full force with it, he set it up at the right time in my life. Okay. Because I feel if he would have set it up back then I wouldn't be where I am right now. So big ups to the big man up there. Being a woman in a barbershop is very difficult. You know, when I first cut my hair and I would walk into a barbershop as a woman trying to go into the barbershop to get a haircut, it was really hard. You know, it was difficult. It was awkward. It was a place where I didn't want to be, you know. So I hated going into the barbershop. And at that point, you know, I bought myself some little Walgreens clippers or some little, you know, of the lower end wall clippers. And I just started cutting my own hair, you know, at that time. And I started lining myself up with some crappy trimmers, and that's just how I would get by. I would cut my own hair because I hated being a woman in a barbershop. So being a woman in a barbershop is not easy. Being a woman in a barbershop just to get a haircut is not easy, let alone being a woman standing behind the chair to actually cut these guys who immediately when they walk through the door and they see me and they see the next barber who, you know, is a male, immediately their first thought is, I want to go to him. Regardless of whatever status or whatever, you know, he has worked himself up to, just the simple fact that I'm a woman, you can already see the questions running through their head. Can she cut hair? I've never had a girl cut my hair. You know, I've had men sit in my chair and they're literally just like stiff. You know, like they come in, they sit down and they're just like slowly sitting there. And then, you know, I turn them around, ask them what it is that they want. And they're very vague and very short, and I have to pretty much use my imagination and my creation to create what it is that they want because they're nervous and I can feel their nervousness. So I have to use, you know, I have to use like my own skill set to really make sure that I knock it out of the park. And that's what being a female barber is about, is you have to overcome these obstacles every day in the shop. You have to get past, you know, people's questions every day in the shop. You're gonna constantly be asked, how long have you been cutting hair? That's gonna be most of the time the first things that come out of their client's mouth is, how long have you been cutting hair, you know? But you have to have thick skin. As a woman in this industry, that's what I've learned. You have to have thick skin. If you take everything personally, and if you take everything to heart, and if you just make, if you take these things and you let them upset you and make you mad, you're not gonna go anywhere. You know, you're not gonna excel, and you're not gonna be able to do good work. So you have to kind of just let things roll off of your back, and you have to smile at the end of the day and just, you know, shake things off. Because you are in the most, I don't even know if this is the right word I want to use, you're in the most sexist industry, or sexually discriminating industry, or gender discriminating industry, how whatever the word is or the terminology. You are in an industry that is still to this day male dominated, and still to this day is considered a man's job. Knowing that and being aware of that and understanding that you're coming into a place where they feel that this is their place and this is where they can go to get away from their problems in their lives, and where they can talk about women and talk about whatever else they want to talk about, you have to understand that you are in their territory. And of course, when you come into somebody's territory, they're gonna be, you know, they're gonna look at you funny or walk around you or whatever the case may be. But you have to understand that they don't intentionally do it. It's not intentional. A barbershop has always been a man's place. And now us women are trying to come in and trying to excel in this place that's always been a man's place. So we have to understand that we are walking into unfamiliar territory for us and for them. So you have to use that understanding that you have of that, and you have to really just get past it, and you have to build tough skin, and you have to build a rapport with your clients and make sure that you know, they come back. You know, I chose this as my lifelong career and what I'm gonna do until I can't work anymore. And my goal is to open doors for a lot of women who are sitting there and who are thinking about becoming barbers and who have just been discouraged. I want them to know that, you know, it's possible. It's possible to be a successful barber. It's possible to do anything that you want to do. It's possible, and I'm living proof of that, you know. I'm living proof that as a woman, you can succeed as a barber, you know. My goal is to really just get that message out there, and my goal is to be on YouTube and to grow my YouTube channel so that people can actually see that, hey, girls do know how to cut hair, and we cut too. We can cut too, you know what I mean? And my goal is to just reach as many souls as possible, regardless if you're male or female. That's my my ultimate goal is to reach as many people as possible to open their eyes to the fact that we can come in and we can cut hair and we could take over this industry too. There's room for us too. There's millions of people in this world, and there's more than enough heads for us all to cut, male or female. You know, that is my goal as a woman. My goal as a woman is to be a voice for all these other women and to open their eyes to success and to open their eyes to the possibilities of stepping outside of your comfort zone. Because trust me, I stepped outside of my comfort zone. You know, I was working for a big corporation and I absolutely hated my job. Every day I would wake up and I would dread going into work. But what I wanted to do and what I knew was my passion, which is barbering, what I wanted to really take on and do, so many people told me I could not because I'm a woman. So many people told me girls can't cut hair. So many people told me that there's no girls in a barbershop. Well, I'm a girl, I'm a barber now, and I'm in a barbershop. So it's possible. It's possible, it's doable, just as long as you put your mind to it. You can do whatever you want to do. What really inspired me to be a barber is, you know, I would go into a barbershop and I absolutely hated it. It was the worst place to be as a woman with short hair trying to get a haircut. And one time I had cut off all my dreads because I had short hair, then I grew dreads, and I cut off all my dreads and I wanted to get a fade, a Miguel fade. I made an appointment. I went into a shop. The barber who cut my hair was absolutely the worst, and not skill wise. He was absolutely the worst in the fact that he did not want to cut my hair. He kept telling the other barber who was initially supposed to cut my hair, but when he saw me walk in, he didn't want to cut it. Who initially was supposed to cut my hair, he kept telling them, "You owe me, you owe me, you owe me." And I remember sitting there and I was like, "What the hell does that mean? Like, what does that mean? You owe me." After that, I didn't go to a barbershop for a long time. And then when I had moved to Pittsburgh, California, and I was like, you know, I really want a good haircut. I'm tired of cutting my own hair. Like, I want somebody to cut my hair. And I remember I walked into Concord Mall, and I walked into Empire Barbershop, and I met Austin. This guy was so welcoming. He was so open. He didn't make me feel bad for being a woman with short hair in a barbershop. You know, he was polite. Anytime that he would cut my hair, he was always like on time, always talking, always just made me feel comfortable. And at that point, I was like, you know what? I'm going to barber college. And I don't know if he knows this or if he will ever even see this, but he literally pushed me to take that next step. And I remember I didn't even tell him that I wanted to be a barber or that I thought about barbering. I remember just in my head, I was like, wow, like this is what I always imagined a barber to be, and I'm gonna be that. And I'm not gonna let anybody continue to tell me I can't do it or I can't be it. So I enrolled like 2 or 3 months later, and I went to barber college. And I told myself that I was going to be one of the women in this industry who's gonna be a pioneer for other women in this industry, and who's gonna try to help open some other doors for other young women like me who want to do this but have always been discouraged, you know, and who have always let other barbers or other people discourage them with their experiences. And that's what I told myself. And he doesn't know that. Austin doesn't know it, but like he literally inspired me. He inspired me to become a barber and to become a damn good barber and to really follow my dreams. You know, barbering is all I have left. I can't go back to retail because I know it would just kill me. And there's nothing else in this world that I can see myself doing or that I know I would enjoy doing. So literally barbering is all that I have left, you know? There isn't anything else that I dream about doing. I dream about cutting hair. That's crazy. When you dream about doing something, that's what you're really supposed to be doing, you know? Not many people can say, oh, I dream about going to work, or I dream about getting to my job and doing my job. No, not many people can say that. Once you can actually say that, then man, you have literally just found your passion, and you have literally just found what it is that you are meant to do. So barbering's all I have. I don't think about anything else. I don't breathe anything else. This is what I want to do. It is great satisfaction when I can make somebody feel good about themselves. You know, it brings me much joy when I can execute a hairstyle or a picture that they brought in, and I execute it, and they're happy with themselves, and they're happy with me, and they feel good, and they walk out of the store, and they're like, man, God, feel good. Barbering is what I was meant to do. So I figured I'd finish the end of this little documentary web series telling a story about myself being in my house, so that you guys can really see that I'm not in the barbershop all day. I actually do have a home that I come to. Close the door so my dogs don't get out. Anyways, I want to thank all of you guys for watching. I want to really just put it out there that if you stuck through this and watched the whole 15, 20 minutes, however long this video ends up being, I really thank you. I really appreciate you guys. I really appreciate all the feedback, the comments, the positive words, the negative words, whatever the case may be. Don't mind the loud ass television in the other room, because my sister, she just doesn't turn the TV down. She's hard of hearing. She can't really hear. Thanks, Juice. Appreciate it.
Love ya.
But this web series is going to continue on. It's going to be throughout the year. So stick around. Keep an eye out for the next female barber that I go ahead and get their story out there, so that you can kind of understand what it is that we go through, our struggles and everything. Please subscribe to my channel to keep up with this. Like I said, it's a web series. It's called I'm a Barber and I'm a Woman, obviously. So hit that subscribe button, comment, like, any feedback. The next series will be 1,000 times better, I promise you guys, because I'll actually be able to like be in control of the camera and stuff like that. This one was a little difficult because I had to work with what I had, which wasn't a lot. So again, thank you guys. I appreciate all of you. Stay tuned. See you later.